fallout on this Microsoft TikTok back and forth with David Bahnsen of the Bahnsen Group. But David, where do you see this going, and how can we see the parent company here keeping its word that this will be an American spinoff, that the parent company said will move out of the United States, clear the way? You know, that's a promise made. Some of those cosmetic moves are maybe welcome, but how do we know that all of this stuff, chicanery that's been charged, magically goes away with a transaction like this?
Well, first, Neil, in your defense as to why you didn't understand what the president was talking about as far as the country taking a piece of the deal, is because you're an American and you're not used to such insane things being said about a private transaction. That sounds like what the Chinese Communist government would say about a private transaction, that they are going to take a piece of it because they can. So that was by far the most surreal part of his comments. But let me answer your question. Listen, this whole thing is so difficult because, first of all, I have kids who are obsessed over TikTok, and I desperately want them to stop using it so much, even though they made me do a little TikTok video last night. So you would think I'd be somewhat supportive of what's going on. And I honestly do understand that there has to be some cracking down on these companies where China is overdoing the issues with security. There has to be some regulation. But almost all TikTok users are on an Apple app, believe it or not, iPhone, iPad, etc. If there was violations of those things going on, they would be the best equipped to regulate that. I don't blame the president for wanting to crack down on Chinese ownership of some of these companies, but we have to be concerned about the precedent being set of the U.S. government intervening into a private transaction like this, and then for him to moments ago, as Jackie pointed out, threatening to take a piece of the transaction, it is absolutely un-American.
Quickly, that Microsoft stock is up on this, and it's going to be an expensive transaction if it comes to pass. I've heard figures as high as $100 billion. You know this far better than I. But that, no matter what it costs, it's well worth it. Do you agree with that?
More than likely. First of all, Microsoft has been a good acquirer. Like when you look at the Skype transaction, yes, which I thought was overpriced at the time, and you look at LinkedIn, which I thought was overpriced at the time, they've done very well there. In this case, it's actually a forced sale. So the reason Microsoft's up is because they are buying a very valuable asset at what will inevitably be a discount to market. I'm fully supportive of there being rigorous ability to stop the Chinese government from getting their hands on American data. And I think that a sale of the company is a fine way to go about doing that. I agree that moving it to London and keeping some connectivity to Chinese companies is going to be too many strings attached. But it's just fair to point out that the State Department is not even alleging that they found any of those infractions yet here. So in this case, without that evidence, there is a pretty heavy amount of intervention going on. Hopefully the sale goes through, everybody's happy, and we move on, and the government doesn't demand a piece of the transaction. In case you can't tell, that part has really bothered me today.
I don't feel like such an idiot now, because if one of the most widely respected guys on the street is saying that, and Jackie is raising some serious concerns about that, then yeah, I'm not a complete doofus, despite all these people emailing just the opposite. Guys, thank you both very, very much.
Thank you.
We'll monitor this very closely.